Hi. In this, here we will see about the different tasks of Bitbake can able to perform, and we can categorize that different tasks of Bitbake. If we will start with that, the category of normal recipe build tasks, which is the one. These build tasks are applicable for all the recipes, and which may or may not be present during that particular recipe building, during the building of a recipe. And we have another category called manual recipes, manual task, something like this task will not be get executed when we initiate that building of any recipes. This manual tasks are used to something like cleaning that the particular recipe, or list the tasks near different tasks present inside tasks of that particular recipes. All those things can be checked using this manual task. And we have an image related task. These are all the tasks used for creating the images, like a rootfs or test image, boot image. All those tasks are related with the image. And we have another category called kernel related task, which will be used and applicable only for a Linux kernel building. Other recipes apart from the Linux kernel cannot use these tasks inside that. We will see each and every task and their descriptions over here. And we have a manual normal recipes build task. Do underscore build is the function, is the default task for all the recipes. And do underscore compile basically compiles that the complete source code, and it has the subdivision to do compile ptest base. Basically it compiles the runtime test suite over the compiled source code included in the software. And do underscore configure basically configure the source with respect to build time options. And we have, suppose the build time, during that build time the package A is going to get compiled for x86, that will be get configured for the x86. If suppose it has been configured, for example we are going to compile for a BeagleBone Yocto, then it has to get compiled for a ARM. Something like it will be configures that particular recipes for the with respect to that the current build time options. And we have the configure ptest, and basically configures that runtime test suite which is included inside the source basically. And we have the function called do underscore deploy, which basically writes the output files that are to be deployed. And we have something like a distro data. This task provides the information about the recipes. And do underscore fetch, we have this one to fetches the source code. And do underscore image, which initiates that image generation process. And do underscore image complete, which completes that image generation process. And do underscore install will have something like copies that the packages that needs to be installed. And do underscore install ptest base copies that runtime test suite to the whole holding area. And apart from these normal recipes, we have the additional one which does that, something like a do underscore package, which analyzes the content of holding area. And do package QA runs that quality assurance check over the packaged data, that is build the output, is checked with for a quality assurance. And we have, as we've seen, we have different kind of packaging technology, Debian based or IPK based or Tor based. Different kind of packages can be created with the respective task functions, something like a do package, write underscore DB, write underscore IPK, write underscore Tor, makes that the respective package building accordingly, package creations accordingly. And we have something like a do underscore package data that saves that metadata informations generated by the do underscore package. And we have something like a do underscore patch, which basically locates and applies the patch files into the source code. For example, we have something like we wanted to add some patches into the particular source. That, for example, we have built based on BeagleBone Yocto, a Linux kernel, and that does not support some of the things. Maybe taking the temperature sensor, that does not present inside the Linux configurations or Linux driver. Maybe we are applying our own patch inside to that Linux kernel source before start building. That can be done using the do underscore patch. And we have something like a do underscore poplate LIC, which is something like a, which writes that license informations that are collected. And we have do underscore poplate SDK, which creates a file and directory structure for an, which creates something like a installable software development kit that can be used for further by the application developer. Basically that mostly that do populate SDK that can be, that will be used to generate something like a meta toolchain or something like a meta SDK software development kit, that will be used by the and something like if suppose you are developing a middleware, that it will be generated with the software development kit and the APIs. That application developer will use that middleware APIs to create the application. Those kind of a scenario that we will be using do populate SDK. And we have sysroot, which is will be subset of a do underscore install. And we have the functions to remove do rm underscore work, rm underscore work all, which basically removes the work files accordingly. And suppose if suppose we are downloading the tar file from git or any somewhere in the repository, that has to be unpacked. Basically do underscore unpack task does the unpacking of the source code into the working directory. And apart from this, we have the manual task that we will see in the upcoming sessions, that we will play with this whatever we have gone through over here with the recipe of maybe Bitbake. And I have the recipe Linux hyphen Yocto, which basically does the, yeah, I think since it is already compiled, it doesn't do anything. And maybe we can do that by cleaning this, and we can confirm maybe Bitbake. We will see that manual also, that manual task, how the manual task can be used over here. And this manual task check PKG, it checks for the provided information about the, it provides the information about the recipes, and check URI validates whether the recipe's source URI is correct or not. And it has the clean, which removes all the output files. And we have clean all, which removes all output files and shared state information. And clean NS state, clean all does remove the downloaded sources also. And the clean NS state only removes that output and shared state cache for the target. And we also have something like a list task, which defines all the tasks for that particular target, basically. That we can do something like this. Maybe here, I'm going to do something like linux-yocto. And how can we run this manual task? Maybe we can use -c. This is the one, -c. And then the task name we can give, that basically that a normal recipe task also can be run in a similar manner, like a manual task. Maybe I can do something like a list of tasks. This provides what are all the tasks that that this particular linux-yocto has to gone over. Something like we have do underscore unpack, which basically needed, we will be getting the tar file from the Linux kernel repository, and it has to be get unpacked. And we have the do build, which is a default task, and bundle init ramifiers. Something like a bundle init ramifiers combines something like a Linux kernel image and then the RAM disk file system. These are all with respect to that kernel related tasks that we will be seeing. And we have the we got the list of informations over here. Maybe we can do something like a cleaning that one, and maybe bitbake linux-yocto-c clean this. Maybe how can we confirm this? I am going to, once it got built, we will be having the deploy images and then BeagleBone Yocto. Then we will be having something like a izet image, that which is a kernel image. I'm going to do something like over here, bitbake linux-yocto, then -c, then clean. Yeah, now if we see something like a tmp deploy images and then BeagleBone black, maybe I can do something like this, ls temp, so that my face is overriding. Yeah, like a BB class, I'm overriding that your class. Yeah, BB class got overrided in the Bitbake. Similar way that your class, I'm overriding your class. Yeah, informations over here. I am going to check whether izet image is present now after the clean. There is no izet image. Basically, that all the output files related with the linux-yocto recipes got cleaned up by using the -c clean. The clean task has been run over here. And maybe we can see that something like a bitbake. How we can see now? If suppose we run something like a linux-yocto, and we can do something like -c clean s state that will clean the shared state informations also, that it provides something like a cleaning from the disk clean. It reconfigures the kernel again, and it starts a building basically. Then we have something like suppose we wanted to do that the compilation, the Linux kernel compilation or configuration that we wanted to do, and I'm going to do linux-yocto-c and I'm going to do configure. The configure needs to be unpacked. The sources has to be unpacked since we removed that the shared state informations. that now the it is updating the kernel and metadata, and it basically that does the configuration. It will, it won't build, it does up to the configurations basically. The kernel underscore config me, which applies that default configurations and does the configurations accordingly. Over here, that config we will see the config me more detail in the kernel related tasks. Now we got compiled. Now we have seen something like something has gone through, but we does not know what all the tasks it has been got executed. Maybe we can do something like I'm going to do clean s state again, so that to get to know that. Yeah, I just cleaned again. Maybe in order to have that clear informations, that we can do basically that the Linux kernel, the building of Yocto Bitbake just overwrites all those things. Once the task has been completed, next task, all those things get overridden into that particular line of information. Maybe we can use something like a Bitbake Linux hyphen Yocto, then cat hyphen. This will give something like the more informations continuously. We can able to see that it was not overridden, it was doing one by one. Then we will know that what are all the tasks it is doing. It does that do underscore unpack, do underscore prepare, and we have the kernel checkout, and over here do underscore kernel metadata, and validates the branch. All those things are happening over here. Do underscore kernel configure, populate license. All we can able to see that clearly, that which are all the task has been executed and what is the result of it. And we can able to see by using the cat hyphen, so that we will be getting the clear idea. Yeah, now the kernel configuration is going through, and maybe it needs to get compiled that Linux kernel. Yeah, it may take some time to get compiled. Yeah, between that, during that time, we can see about some of the things over here, the kernel related task. That's something we can do over here. The kernel related task, something like compile kernel modules. If we wanted to run the run the step that has to build that kernel modules over here. And if suppose we wanted to make the different between the configurations, original and changes by the user, and we have the kernel checkout and kernel configuration check, that it validates that current kernel configurations with the do menu configurations basically. And we have config me, which we have gone through that, which basically assembles and merges all the config fragments into that. And if suppose we wanted to launch that like a kernel menu config, if you wanted to do, then we can do hyphen c kernel menu config, kernel underscore menu config, which basically launches that menu configuration tool. And we can do something like a kernel metadata, which collects all the features required by the kernel to build. And we have then a menu config, do underscore menu config. We can run this task to get that menu config user interface of the kernel. And we can have something like a saved default configuration, which basically creates that the default configuration that has been created, and it will be used instead of the default configuration basically. And we have the shared work directory. It copies that the files required for the build into the work directories. And we have the size check. If suppose we wanted to have the kernel size should be within that the kernel image max size, then we can this size check will do that basically. And we have something like a do underscore strip, which basically removes the strips the sections named within in the region of kernel image strip extra sections, and we have that something like a do underscore validate underscore branches, which ensures that the machine and metadata branches are specified as per the source revisions of the kernel basically. Let's see whether it got compiled over here. Yes, it's still going on, and we can see that some of the things over here, and the kernel tasks over here, and native, that's something like now we are in do underscore compile here, and we have the configurations are done, and what are the tasks which has been completed, we can gone through over here. Maybe like here, and the first step is the do underscore fetch, which fetches the sources, and the sources are already fetched, and it does the unpack, and it does the recipe underscore sysroot, and once it is done, it does the do underscore unpack and kernel checkout, and then kernel source, kernel checkout over here, and we have something like a validate the branches and metadata, and over here the kernel underscore metadata and kernel sanity check and do underscore patch and config me, and then we have something like a do underscore populate license, and then do underscore kernel configure config me and do underscore configure, and we have something like a kernel config check. It's also started and confirmed. Here we have something like a do underscore compile got started, and we may have to wait for some more time, maybe 10-15 minutes, and we will continue from there. Yeah. Yes, that do underscore compile got completed successfully, and do underscore shared work directory and kernel link images and shared work directory is completed. Now we have get started with the do compile kernel modules. It's building that kernel modules basically over here, and here we have something like whenever we do Bitbake Linux Yocto, it's basically the Bitbake and Linux Yocto we are giving, and Bitbake just gets the list of tasks, what all the thing has to be done for that particular recipe, and for example here it starts from something like a do underscore fetch, unpack, kernel populate, and check a license, image, the branches checking, all those things. What all the list of tasks are available for that particular task has been manipulated by the Bitbake, and it creates the task graph over here, and we can see over here, and Bitbake executes that each and every task occurred based on that the task graph has been created, and that these are all the things has been done by the Yocto build core system. And we are developing our own recipes to build our own sources, then what is the task that has to be done within this do underscore kern, do underscore compile, or do underscore configure? That is the developer's option that provides something like a very customizable build systems that we can make any kind of the sources can be built using that the Yocto systems Yocto build system provides the flexibility to build any kind of systems accordingly. Here we got compiled with the kernel modules, and then we have something like a do underscore strip, and once the stripping of that extra strips options, and it checks for the size which is related with the kernel image commands, and it does the do underscore install. That install out copies that output files into the copies the images into the respective output file. That is something like a copies into the temp deploy images. And it suppose we have the option to build the bundle the initramfs. It does the kernel and initrd into the single image, and we have something like a package data, and it does the quality assurance, and it does the do underscore deploy, and it does the package write rpm, and that it does that all the task in a proper and a sequence or set of ordered manner, so that the build process will be completed accordingly over here. And we have gone through that the how the Linux kernel has been created, can be compiled over here with the different task. The task has been completed with the last one of writing the RPM over here. And we can see that the build flow which we have seen over here, that it matches over here. That maybe I am going to that first Yocto fundamental architecture over here. It's basically it starts with the source switching and patches the application and configures, compiles, and then generates, and it does the RPM and QA test, and it reaches to the, since it is a package generation, the recipes of the Linux kernel only gets done. It generates the RPM and does the quality assurance, and during the time of image generations, all the recipes informations will be created by the image generation. That is something like a core image minimal. We can say that this is the recipe of the core image minimal, that it combines all the informations, all the recipes outputs, and generates into the embedded Linux image. In case of a core image minimal, if suppose we wanted to do application SDK, then all the libraries and everything got created, that will be created like a application development SDK over here. And here we have something like a, apart from that, in order to do image related task, we have that something like a do underscore boot image, which provides something like a creates a bootable live image over here, and bundle initramfs over here, and which combines the RAM disk and kernel together in order to form a single image. And we have the do underscore rootfs, which creates the rootfs file system for an image, and a test image, which boots an image and performs a runtime test. And if suppose we have defined the task test image auto, then it performs the runtime test once after it has been built. And this gives that brief information about the different Bitbake tasks are available and how it can be used within that Yocto build system to create that respective output files, and how those things are get used to deployed into the respective directory. That we have seen, gone through that. Maybe we shall go into little deeper and with respect in inside the sources, how these are all the things are happening. Now we have seen over here with the output of it is doing something like do underscore deploy and do underscore package and do underscore compile, do underscore configure of the Linux Yocto. We will go into little deeper and what is happening inside. That we will see in the next sessions and going forward with. Till then, happy Yocto, enjoy Yocto. Bye.